What does it mean? This first of all means good video footage, and it reassures that we got the bikes for ourselves. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for tuning in with me today. And as you can tell, I have got a guest today. This is JJ. And JJ, let me ask you, have you ever caught a fish?
No.
He's never even caught a fish, never thrown a rod. And I do not have any push buttons on me. All I've got is the rods you see here. And he's gonna be using this one right here. And I may even give this rod to him once we're done. So we're gonna try to catch some bluegill out here and then eventually throw those bluegill out. If we can catch some big bass, put them on. That is the mission today. You guys stay tuned. Hopefully you enjoy the video. Let's get into it. First things first, unhook the hook from the little circle down there. It's right there. Ball up a little piece of bread, man. That's it. Here's how you do it. Form it around there. Let me show you how to cast it. Here, hold that. Always check your drag. You see how tight it is? Feel it. If you were to hook a big fish, he's breaking this line or the rod. So watch, here's how to cast it. Take it like this, you grab your finger, and then you just release it as soon as you want to. These are a little stubborn right here. Look at that. Now we'll use this one for bait. I got him. There you go. All right, now put a piece of bread on there and try to catch one yourself. And we'll go ahead and get a bass rod out there. Just like that. Yep. Now open up the bail. Open up the bail always. Just flip it over and release right when you're about to, right at the cherry spot. Make sure it's not hung up on the tip right there. Just don't hesitate. Just do it. Flip the bail back over. This piece right here is called a bail. Yep, don't hesitate. Better. That was a lot better. Give it a little action. Yep, you got some coming to it. Might need a recast out here. And you always want it to look like this. If it's anywhere else, it's not right. So first things first, reel it, always reel it to where it's not going to hook you in the back of the head. So about 2 to 3 feet, right? Now you grab with this hand, with your right hand, and you grab it like that. So when you go to throw it, release right at that cherry spot, release your finger. Try it. So just flip that bail over and you're ready to roll. As long as that bail's right here and you grab your finger, you're ready to roll. Try it, look. I'll spin it around for you. It's already ready to go. It's what I like to call locked and loaded. Whoa, you gotta make sure you hold it with your finger. That's the only thing holding line in. No, you gotta hold the line. Now it's ready to go. Look, grab it with your finger. Yep, grab, yep, there you go. Now you're ready to roll. Yep, try it. You gotta make sure you're letting it go. Watch slow motion. I'm about to show you slow motion of what it would look like. Look. Ooh. You see how I let go of my finger? Here, let's catch one. Here, try this one out.
Wait, where's the spring?
I think you got one, man. I think you got a fish on, brother. Yeah, just reel it. It's your first fish, bro. Look at him. No, we'll throw him back. He's really pretty. Feel him. Watch out for his fins. Watch out for his fins. We'll wash him off. See his fins poking? Those things will poke you. We're gonna let him go. Look at all those tadpoles. There he goes. All right, JJ is over there chasing lizards while I'm over here chasing bass, but we can catch a good one. That's my main goal. That's a big fish right there. 4-pounder right there. We need to put a 4-pounder in his hands. That's what's gonna get him fired up. That's what's gonna do it for him. We need him. I'm about to do it. I'm about to do it, man. Oh my gosh. Boys, my man JJ's never caught a fish, and there's a 5.5 over there. Oh, here he is. The run is real. Oh, wow. Easy, easy, easy. Let me pluck me one. Thank you, bro. But you'll be thanking me later. You think that's true, bro? Easy, easy. Big, 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 big fish. Oh, he's hungry. He's hungry. Got him. All right, come on. All right, hold on to the rod, JJ. I'm expecting you not to let this rod go, bro. All right. Loosen that drag up, stiff rod. Here we go. Here, here, take the rod. Here, here, one second, buddy. Gotta let me do my thing. Dang. All right, here he comes. Stand back. Wait, this might be a little too big for him, but I think he can get it. Oh, he just ate, I think. Look at him. Look at how fired up that fish is getting. He ate it. Here. Yes, baby. Yes. Let's go. Yes, JJ. Yes, bro. One second. Don't pull. One second, JJ. Let him run. Yes, JJ. Nice fish, man. Yes, bro. Good fish. 5.5. Who caught that, you? Here, JJ. Hold in the mouth. Got teeth.
Is he gonna bite?
No, it doesn't. Look, yeah. I'm holding it.
Where?
In the mouth, right where I'm holding him. Yep. You got him? Hold him. Don't drop him. Promise me you won't drop him. Look at that. Hold him up like this. That fish is almost as big as him. Yeah, take a picture. Heck yeah. That's a good fish, bro. No, we're throwing them back. I just do YouTube videos.
What's your channel?
It's T-Tac Living. Yes, sir. We're going to let JJ let him go. So, JJ, this is how you hold him. Just like I'm holding him. Yep. Hold firm on his lip. And don't bend his neck. Let's let him go. T-Tac Living. T-T-A-K. Here, just take this wristband. You can have it.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. All right, let's let him go. Easy. Hey, he's going. She got fired up. Thank you, girl. Nice catch, bro. Awesome. Okay, we appreciate it. We'll probably catch them. Thank you, bros. Have a good day. Tell your friends about the channel. Always helps. That was a big fish. Wow. That was insane. Look, that fish got so fired up right there. Was doing circles around my bait. And then I yanked it out of the grass and he just inhaled it. But we got JJ on his first fish. It's got me out of breath. It's got me out of breath, JJ. I didn't even catch him. That was exciting. To the other side. This is where the fishing begins. I think they're out there. Throw it straight out. Kind of angled. From where you're at, throw it straight out. Bread came off. Try it. Make sure that bell is closed or you won't be able to hook them. This may or may not be a good idea. Look, just like this. So you hold it. Now you let it hit the bottom. It takes about 4 seconds. And now you just jig it like that. Try to catch him, man. I'm rooting for you, bro. Slow it down, slow it down. You gotta jig it. Make it look like a worm on the bottom. Dang. That was the first fish we had off artificial, I think. Dang, was that the fish that just now ate it, man? That's ridiculous. Good one. You never want loose line in there. Here you go. When you get ready to cast next, let me know. I'll show you. How's it looking? A little trick is pull it fast, yeah. Let's see what the spool looks like. Clean.
Buttery.
This is not looking good, boys. Yeah, this one definitely ain't coming out. So JJ, we're gonna stick you with the back with the spinning reel. So get used to the spinning reel, bud. It's the best way to learn. All right, they're right here, JJ. Probably about 15 of them. Put on a big bread ball. We like to see it. You see them boiling? Just throw it in that general area. You'll hook up, man. See if we can get these fish to strike on this thing. I'm telling you guys, this is the juice. This is the juice bait for any size fish, man. Oh, he'll eat it. Yep. Juice bait. Threw it on a boil of fry, and what do you know? Yes, sir. Three jumps. Look at the chasers. You see the chasers on them? Four jumps. That's a strong bass. Let's see if we can get these chasers close up. Look at that. Awesome. and they choke this thing, boys. Thing I love about this bait is you can just slow roll it, give it some pauses, or you can jig this thing. Either way, it's gonna catch fish every time. Here's that little small guy. I'm telling you guys, this is the OG bait. If you've ever struggled catching fish, this is a little life hack for you. Because these fish are literally sitting right in front of me. And they're getting fired up on it. Here it is, right on some fries. So this is pretty much post-spawn here. Let's see if he'll eat it. It doesn't seem to be too intrigued by it. He did look at it, just didn't bite it. Oh my goodness, man. There's a lot of action going on today. I'll tell you that. Those are bluegill out there. That's what's crazy about it. Those aren't even bass. Keep trying them. Those are good fish. This one's hungry. But it's a little small for this bait. That's why I can't get her to commit. She just can't get the whole bait. What? Oh my goodness. That was sick. Oh. So just to show you guys, just like I told you. These baits, man, are wild. Let JJ try a Kai Tech. Little 3-inch swing impact. Blue red pearl. Smells like squid. Blockhead. So these blockhead jig heads pair up perfect with the 3-inch Kai Tech. All right, let me see your line. All right, watch how I tie this knot. Uni knot. You take it, the tag, this is called the tag end. This little piece right here, this is called the main line. Take your tag end and your main line just like that, and then you just pull it and wrap it around, right? Then you pull your fingers out. Now you got the main line and a tag end line. Now you just do 6 to 7 spins depending on the line size. I do 7 with light line, 6 with heavy. Wet the line and then pull it tight just like that. Now you're ready to rock. All right, let's see how this green pumpkin works. There's a little bass right here. He's pretty fired up on it. Yeah, he's fired up on it. Definitely fired up on it. Generally, once I get them fired up, they'll definitely eat. But I say it all the time, if you're around a bass that's bedding, if you can hit it across some sticks or across the bottom and really get it stirred up, that's what really makes this fish mad. So he's gonna be one of the ones that hit by reaction. Yep, I knew it. Quick release. If you're smart enough, you'll get back in, buddy. No, we got you. Here, go in there, buddy. Thank you. Here's two more right here. And he nosed it. He nosed it, bro. Oh, he got it. He got it. Yep. Chunker. Ooh. Barely hooked. Thank you, girl. Let me see how you hooked it. Oh yeah. Take it like this, put it straight to the top, go in, boom. There's one up underneath the bluegill right now. Yep, he ate, I think. He's about to get it. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Okay. I see you, bro. Free spool, Glenn. Free spool, Glenn. Oh, fly bait. Awesome to see. Pretty dope. Head shake. Let him run. Got him. Pretty dope. That fish came up and absolutely hammered it. It was a struggle for her to get it, but she got it. Here's another one right out here. He's too dead for anything to want him. All right, here's a little better. I think we can catch him. We just gotta stand far away. See if you can catch one. They're out here. So the backstory on this fish is I've caught this fish before. And I know he'll eat, but he's a hard-headed fish. I just want to see if he'll eat this bait. We just hit him right on his head. Again. See, he wants it right up against the bank, and that's what I'm about to do. I'm about to perfect this shot right here, and I'll show you guys exactly how I do it. So he's sitting there looking right underneath that branch. What I'm going to do is put it right underneath that branch, get him fired up. Once he's fired up, it makes it so much easier for me to actually catch him. Yep. Right underneath the branch, just like I told you. Goodness. Oh, man. Wow. Spark Shad does it again, man. Does it again. He's hooked good. I love these owner hooks. Blockhead. Come out of that timber. No, 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 no. Jeez, that's good. Yes, baby, that's good blood. Gotcha. Let's go. 3.5, baby. Love to see it. Threw it right up underneath this branch and he absolutely dwelled it. 3-pounder, not bad. Look at how he choked that thing. Mega Bass Spark Shad. I don't know what else to tell you guys. These things are fire. is this little dude. Pretty sure there's quite a few bass right here. Reaction bite type guy. I think he'll eat it if it goes right by his face. Yep, yep, he tried it. He tried to. There's the female right there. Thank you, girl. Quick release. What happened, bud? Let me see. Usually what I do is I just rip the branch off and I'll take it like that. Let that branch go. Yep. Is it broken? No. We'll probably fish for about 15 more minutes. Is that fun? Mm-hmm. Just throw it out and reel it. That's what's going to catch him. You want to see him? He's got fins. Watch those top fins. You got to hold him. Here, hold him up. Here, don't drop him. Hold him up. Make sure you can see his face. Yeah. All right, throw him back. Let him go easy. There he goes.
There you go.
Good sport, JJ. So a place like this is gonna be very hard for you to maneuver. I mean, OG bait, man. That mega bass is absolutely OG. They choke it. Look at it. Absolutely choked. I mean, goodness gracious, they choked this bait. Oh, thank you, buddy. Can't get all the way down there because I know there's a copperhead. No, I just know they're out here. All right, let's keep moving. So, guys, as you can tell, it's getting super hot. I'm sweating super bad. And JJ is right beside me, and the number one question that I have for him is, JJ, did you have fun today?
Yes.
And JJ caught a 5.5-pound bass for his first fish ever. Leave it in the comments if a 5.5-pound bass was your first fish, because I guarantee you most people do not catch a big fish like that for the first time. Hope you guys enjoyed. You guys stay safe, stay blessed. Let that drag sing.